Welcome back to the channel. It is your boy Jay the Sneaker Guy coming at y'all today with a review and on feet. And as y'all seen from the title and the intro, we got the Yeezy 350 V2s in the cloud white colorway. Another 350, what can I say, y'all? And man, what these 350s are starting to, they've been starting to look repetitive, man. They are all starting to look alike. But anyways, I'm still hit you guys with that reviewing on feet. Hope everybody's having a great, blessed, and awesome day. If this is your first time stopping through and checking out any of your boy or any of the family's content, man, y'all make sure y'all hit that subscribe button and be a part of the family that we have. We are on the grind and we are striving to reach a goal of 5,000 subscribers, y'all. And if you guys would, go ahead and hit that button and help us out reach that goal. It would be greatly appreciated. In advance, man, welcome to the family. But let's go ahead and get into these shoes, y'all. As you guys can see on your left, my right, we have two pairs of Yeezys back here, man. I don't know if y'all could kind of tell the difference, but we have the Yeezy 350 V2 Lund Marks on the top, and on the bottom, we have the Yeezy 350 V2 Cloud Whites, in which we will be reviewing today. But I brought them both out, man, just to kind of show y'all, man, what I mean as far as this repetitiveness, man. Like, Yeezy and Adidas, they keep coming out with these, you know, these soft color type shoes that are all just kind of running together, man. So to be honest, y'all, these Cloud Whites, I'm not going to keep because I like my Lund Marks. That's kind of like the only ones of that kind as far as a light shaded shoe. I got rid of my Statics, so I just need one light shaded, you know, 350, and I'm good. I don't need to pile up on shoes that kind of look, you know, the same like that, man. It's a waste of money. So I'm getting off them Cloud Whites. They probably gonna be gone by the time y'all see this video. But anyways, man, we're gonna go ahead and get into it. I'm gonna show y'all a quick look at these before I can get y'all a comparison between the two. But bam, those are your Yeezy 350 Cloud Whites, which released on, what date was it? Yesterday. I forgot what date yesterday was. Let me check my watch, y'all. Y'all excuse me. September 22nd. So these released September 21st. Excuse me, I'm saying today's date, but these released on the 21st, which was yesterday. And just another 350, as I said, you know, if you don't own a pair, you know, of a light colored 350, you may want to get these, you know. But or if you're just a big 350 collector, you might want to add them to the collection. Me personally, it's not staying in my collection. These, however, like I said, these are my Lund Marks, man. I like my Lund Marks a lot. These are one of the dopest, my opinion, one of the dopest 350 colorways that dropped this year. You got your 3M laces on these. These do not have 3M laces, but you know, you got 3M laces and you got that kind of dirty type look so that they don't get dirty that easy, or they're not noticeably easy. But you got both of them right there, man. And as you can see, you know, you see a slight difference in the color change on both of the shoes, y'all. But I mean, come on, man. Same type of vibe, man. Like, I mean, the further you are, if you got these on feet, you know, you walking with them, like, you don't need two shoes of this type of, you know, type colorway. So for $220, man, I could say that, man. I could buy me something that looks totally different. So, excuse me. These both V2s, they both have the same similar patterns, as you can see. Same type of patterns, they all change, but it's the same thing, just different colorway on both shoes. And let's go ahead and get into this review of the Cloud Whites, y'all. So starting with your outsole on these, you have your translucent bottom, which is in like a cream colorway. You can see through to your Boost on the top half as well as the bottom half. But you had that on your midsole on these shoes. It's more of a white You get a white, not really that milky cream colorway, but you do have that like tab like on the back of the sole, which does have the same color as the outsole. So your midsole is more of a white than it, you know, the bottom outsole is about this color where you can see the color shift in those two. But you have that there, and moving up, you have this, what is this, fly knit, prime knit, I don't know what they call it on these Adidas, my bad, excuse me for that. But you have that, and as you do on all these 350s, you have your pattern that changes, you know, all throughout. It goes into different patterns, and it does have, let me see if it'll pick it up, it does have, you can kind of see it, two tones, like you have like a light, almost like a bleak, if you have some blue jeans and you wash it with the whites, you get that like off, that light blue color. You have that type of shade on this half, and then this goes more into a darker blue to say all this, but this is the only area where you have that lighter blue, and this is kind of the same blue as that of the laces. So you have your rope laces in these that has, like I said, the best way to describe it is like a washed, a bled on white, you know, look. But you have that, you have your translucent stripe here on the side that is like a sail or off-white color, and then it does have that see-through part right here on the side. You can see my finger on the inside, that's the only area right there which is translucent. And moving up from that, you still have that light blue color as I was telling y'all about right there on this half. And then you know, just got all those patterns. You do have that sewn in stitch that splits up the shoe in the back. There's no pull tab on these. They kind of, I guess, did away with the pull tab on the last couple releases of these 350s, but man, they just all starting to look alike to me. But you do have your 3M three stripes on the back. You got that cloud blue look on the inside of these. It reads Adidas Yeezy, as you see. And show you guys a quick look at this size tag. Bang, as y'all can see, if y'all want to pause it, it's not the best look, but I'll try to do what I can. See it there. And this is a size 9. I actually got this personally for myself, man. The reason why I'm starting to go down a half size to my true size on the 350s, because lately, ever since they got this new model, like I would say from the Statics and on, they kind of fixed the sizing on the 350s in my personal opinion. They fit a little bit better, so I can actually go true to size on them. But I still would recommend, if you are purchasing Yeezys for the first time, you don't own a pair of Yeezys, just go a half size up, it won't hurt. Or unless if you want to try to go true to size, you know, you can always take out the insole, but a lot of people don't like doing that. But just, you know, just throwing it out there for sizing. But they fit a little better in my opinion. I did get these, like I said, personal size to get them for myself, but after looking at them, comparing them to my Lundmarks, man, I do not need both these shoes, because like I said, y'all, look, if you're walking, look, just look at that, look, do you see as far as how close they are? Y'all like, what is he doing? But y'all get what I'm saying, right? And let me do the opposite. Like it's not, it's they're too close for a $220 shoe. They're too close. So just me being smart, man, it's my personal opinion. Y'all let me know y'all thoughts on it, man. They just getting too close for me. But it's a dope shoe. If you do not own any light color shoes, or you just, you know, you're just a big fan of 350s, hey, this is for you. But just like I said, man, I can't do it. So I thank y'all for watching the video. Hopefully y'all got something from that. And hopefully y'all like the on feet. It may change some of your minds, it may not. But I'm gonna go ahead and hit y'all with the on feet. I thank y'all for watching. Like I said, if this is y'all first time stopping through, y'all make sure y'all hit that subscribe button and join the family, y'all, cause we are still grinding for that 5K. And I thank everybody for getting me to the point where I'm at right now. It's a blessing. So y'all stay tuned for the next video. It'll be probably my Jordan 12 Royals. And I know I've been slacking, I've been kinda late on the videos, but I'm gonna get back on the grind, y'all. I'm gonna have these early reviews and all that stuff coming to y'all. So y'all stay tuned. But till my next video, your boy Jay the Sneaker Guy is checking out with the Yeezy 350 V2 and the Cloud White, another 350. But yeah, till my next video, yo, I am gone. Peace.